Yes, children. Yes, so we have learned the lessons in geography. The next lesson is your four systems of our earth. Okay, so what is that four systems of our earth? What are the systems are there? What are the systems are there? We have learned lithosphere, we have learned hydrosphere, atmosphere we have learned. So what is the fourth system? Yes, of course, what you think is correct. It is biosphere. What we are going to learn today is about biosphere. Okay, so we are not going to learn the full lesson. What is important that you have to know that we are going to see today. Fine. So yes. So here you can see the four main systems that interact, because each and everything interact. So think, as an individual, I cannot stand alone on the earth. I need the support of others. As an individual, you cannot stand alone on the earth. You need the support of others, because we cannot be the producer, we cannot be the consumer, we cannot be everything. Okay, whatever it is needed, we cannot do everything for us. By us, we cannot do. So what is needed? We have to depend on the others. We have to depend on the others. Same way. Lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, each and everything interact with each other. All these three interact with each other. Imagine we our earth is only filled with atmosphere. It's not possible for the life to exist. If the earth is filled with only lithosphere, it's not possible for the life to exist. Same way, if the earth is full of water, it's not possible for the life to exist. Even underwater plants are needed. So each and everything have their own interaction. So the place where all these three meet is called what? Biosphere. We need air, we need water, we need land. So in that place only we can live, and that is called what? Biosphere. So let's see here, composition of the earth, atmosphere, hydrosphere, okay, biosphere and geosphere. Okay, geosphere already I have told you, it is nothing but the lithosphere. Atmosphere means air, gas, hydrosphere, water, biosphere where the life exists, and geosphere, the land and rock. Yes. So what are the composition of the earth? That's what we have seen already. And the main part is the biosphere. The main system of the earth is biosphere, because that is a place where life exists. All the living beings exist. Okay, so sea life, plants, flying creatures, human, all that exists in the biosphere. Fine. So we can see here a picture, sample picture. Okay, living beings means it's not only the human beings, it is the composition of all the other different living beings. Okay. So the relationship between an organism and its environment is a study of ecology. So what is ecology? You know what is biology, what is physics, what is chemistry, everything you know. What is ecology? The relationship between an organism and its environment is a study of ecology. You can see the picture over there. Each and every living being has its interaction with the other living beings. Okay, next one. Living things interact with non-living things in the biosphere. Mountain or weather conditions such as temperature, cloud, snow, hurricane, etc. All these are the abiotic factors. Why all these are taken environmental factors or the weather conditions? Because certain living beings can live in certain adaptation only. Okay, certain living being can live only in the coldest place, or certain living beings can live only in the hot places. Okay, that is why it is given as environmental factors and the weather factors. Now let us see the role of water in the biosphere. Yes, we know very well, the water is the basic needed for all kinds of living beings. Okay, for all kinds of living beings. So water is very, very, very essential for everything, because it is the basis of all life on our planet Earth. So the hydrosphere is important to the biosphere. Next one, role of the sun for the biosphere. Yes. Yes, sun is very much needed, though it is a heat, or we can say that hot source, it is very much needed. It is very much needed because it gives light, it helps the plants to prepare the food, it helps us to get the daylight. Otherwise, if the sun is not there, what will happen? We will be in dark. Okay, we will be in dark. Even the universe will not function if the sun is not there. So the sun provides the light and heat necessary to maintain life on Earth, and it is the ultimate source of energy. What energy we can derive from the sun? Yes, we can get the solar energy. What energy? Solar energy. So let us see the ocean ecosystem. In that ocean ecosystem too, we have the biotic factors and abiotic factors. Because underwater too, we have the living creatures as well as the non-living things like mountains, stones, rocks, everything we have underwater too. That is why ocean ecosystem consists of biotic and as well as abiotic. So next one, this is the grassland ecosystem. Okay, grassland, you can see some pictures over there. The snakes, mushrooms, so all that are there. What is called ecosystem? We will see that in the further slides. So here you can see some sample food chain. Okay, sample food chain. You can see the trophic level, that is the primary producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, and quaternary consumer. And you can see grassland biome, pond biome, ocean biome. So there you have the question, what is ecosystem? You will get the answer at the end of this slide. So you can see the grassland biome, grass, grasshopper, rat, snake, and hawk. So what do you mean by that? Grass is eaten by the grasshopper, grasshopper is eaten by the rat, rat is eaten by the snake, and snake is eaten by the hawk. And this food chain is called what? We can say that ecosystem. Fine. So next one, pond biome, you can see algae, which is eaten by mosquito larva. Mosquito larvas are there. Then dragonfly larva, then fish, then you can see raccoon. Yes. And next one, ocean biome, phytoplankton, zooplankton, fish, seal, white shark. White shark. So these are all the sample food chains. Other food chains you would have learned in your science. So just to make you aware of that, all these food chains makes the ecosystem. I have shown this. Okay, children. So how the producers, consumers are divided, you can see here one more time. Primary producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, quaternary consumer. Okay, who all are called producers? Who all are called producers? Plants are called producers, or they are called as autotrophs, because they are able to use the light energy which is derived from the sun, which they get from the sun, and they make their own food. Plants make their own food. That is why they are called autotrophs. Are carnivores that eat herbivores. Herbivores are primary consumers, and something that makes its own food is called producer. So on the whole, we have seen as a summary here. So Secondary consumers are carnivores. Herbivores are primary consumers, and something that makes its own food is called producer. And you can see the food chain over here with the arrow mark. Okay, next one, tertiary consumers. Tertiary consumers are carnivores that eat other carnivores. Tertiary consumers are carnivores that eat other carnivores. So you can see here, killer whales, that is a tertiary consumer, they eat another carnivore, killer whales. A dolphin is a secondary consumer because they eat a herbivore. See, one animal which eat a herbivore animal is called secondary consumer. One animal, or we can say that one carnivore which eat the other carnivore is called tertiary consumer. Okay, next one, you can see that other fish kind of structure which is called herring, primary consumer, because they eat only plants. Next one, photoplankton. This plant produces its own food. Now you can understand that you go in the reverse way now from the last bullet. The first one, that is a photoplankton, are the consumers. The primary consumer, second one secondary consumer, and the top one, which is the tertiary consumer. Omnivores. We all are omnivores. Some may say that, ma'am, no, ma'am, we all are non-veg. Okay? So, why we all are omnivores? Because we eat both plants and we eat meat. That is why we all are omnivores. Some may say that, no, ma'am, we eat only the vegetables, or we never eat all these non-veg. Yes, of course. But anyhow, human beings are considered as omnivores. Okay? To sum up, okay, animals that eat only plants, animals that eat only animals, animals that eat both animals and plants. So finally, it is given as humans are also called omnivores. Okay, here children, decomposers. There are some friends for us who decompose everything and prepare the soil and give. And they are called as the friend of farmers. Yes, of course, all these earthworms, they are called as the farmer's friend because they decompose everything and they till the soil and give. Okay, that is why they are called as farmer's friend. Let us see, all these earthworms come under decomposers, bacteria, worms, and fungi. Okay, which are all called decomposers? Bacteria, worms, and fungi, which feed on decaying matter. These decomposers speed up the decaying process that releases mineral salt back into the food chain for absorption by plant as nutrients. Yes, so all this process you would have learnt in your science. Just to recall, I'll telling it. Okay, fine children, hope that you would have understood till that. Yes, so we have seen all these. We have seen the four systems of our earth, composition of the earth, which consists of atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere, and geosphere, which is called lithosphere. And it has four main systems. In that, biosphere plays a very important role because all sea life, plants, flying creatures, humans, all living in the biosphere. So next one, we have seen about the ecology. Living things interact with non-living things in the biosphere. So it consists of biotic factors and abiotic factors. You would have learned it. Okay. And we have seen the role of water in the biosphere. Role of sun for the biosphere. Next one, ocean ecosystem we have seen. Grassland ecosystem. Sample food chains we have seen. And plants are called producers or autotrophs, because they are able to use light energy and produce their own food. And we have seen the consumers are otherwise called as heterotrophs. These consumers are of three types: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Okay, that's what we have seen. Or we can say that primary consumer, secondary consumer, and tertiary consumer. Yes. Okay, children, so let's go for an important part. So which I wanted to say, I said it's a surprise. Okay, fine, children. So what's a surprise is, you're going to learn the next level in your 9th standard. Okay, so we are going to start with the 10th lessons for you all from Monday onwards. Yes? So are you all happy? You are going to learn the 10th portions from Monday onwards. So be happy. So get ready. You will be all the best for your next level. We'll be learning from Monday. Okay, children? Yes? So the very first chapter will be an important chapter and an interesting chapter. Fine, children. So prepare your mind, and you have to be very, very attentive in the class to learn everything, because as we teach, you have to read the lesson every day. Okay, you have to read the lesson every day, because each and every line you have to read and understand the concept. Fine, you have to read and understand the concept apart from the book exercise. You should not depend only on the book exercise. We have to read each and every concept, whatever is taught to you, every day. And if there is any doubt, you have to clarify everything that day itself or in the next class. Fine. So what you have to do is, the first thing is you have to prepare your mind to listen properly. Okay. Yes, because all the playfulness, yes, of course, you can play after that, but please little bit serious from Monday onwards. Yes, children. So I will tell some materials that you can keep it ready. For that, don't be in a hurry, hurry to here and there. Don't be in searching of everything. So have two maps with you ready. One is always, and one more thing, children, for your 10th standard lesson, you will not be marking anything on any political map or river map. Everything will be plain map. Regarding social, everything will be plain map. For example, India, if we say on plain map only, you have to mark all that and you will be marking everything. Like if I give a river like Ganga, you have to mark that river and you have to do it. So don't be expecting with all the territories or anything. Okay, so get ready with two outline maps. If you cannot buy two outline map, already you had some maps, just take an A4 size paper and draw the outline and keep it. Trace it out and keep it. That is enough. Okay, that is enough. Just trace it out and keep it, because it's going to be an outline. So Monday, I'll be waiting for you all to have your maps with you, because we will be starting a geography lesson on Monday. Fine, children. Some students will be very curious to know what lesson we are going to learn. Yes, of course, we are going to learn our India. Okay, our India. Just go through what are the states and capitals, what are the rivers are there in India. Don't be asking questions, ma'am, we don't have the book. Yes, we know that you don't have the book, but we will guide you how to learn it. Only India map, two India map outline. Even if you buy and keep, that's okay. Or you can trace it out and keep. That is far better. Yes, children. So any doubts regarding that? And please practice your handwriting in a better way. Yes, you have to start writing in a neat manner with all the side headings. And you should not be asking, ma'am, whether one line is enough, two lines are enough, all that. Questions should not be asked, because depending on the question, we have to write all the answers. Yes? So really, I'm very happy to see you all, like you are going to learn the 10th portion. Yes? Any other doubt, children? If you have any doubt, you can ask. Just we will have one short quiz for 5 minutes. Very good. So there are no doubts with anyone. Fine. Okay, here be attentive. I'm going to give a short quiz or like an introductory part about India. Okay, introductory part about India. So get ready. You can give your answers in the chat box. Fine. Very good. Okay, children. So which is the capital of our country? Quickly. Yes. Very good, children. Very good. Next one. How many states are there? You have to give the recent update, not the older one. How many states are there? Anybody knows? Yes, different answers are coming. 28, 29. Then, for this question, I will not give you the answer. You just check it out once the class gets over. How many states and union territories as of now? Because you know very well that there are two states which are added to the union territory and one is made as the national capital territory. So find out how many states and union territories are there so that we will discuss it in the tomorrow's class. Okay, according to population, what is our rank? Population, India stands dash in population, which rank? Very good. Second, area wise, area, because all this I have taught you all from fourth standard. Very good. Very good, Ramina. Anybody else? Very good. All the others are giving answer. Good. Seventh. According to area, we are in the seventh place. So that is why we say that India is the seventh largest country. Yes. In which continent we are in? We are in Asia. Very good. Very good, children. How many physical divisions we have in India? How many physical divisions we have in India? Physical divisions means mountains, plains. So how many are there? Okay. Yes, again different answers are coming. Wait. I will just say you count it. Yes, we have mountainous region, we have plain region, we have plateau region, desert region, coastal plains, islands. Totally how many? Very good. Seven, six physical divisions we have. Okay, mountains, plains, plateaus, coastal areas, deserts and islands. Very good, children. Okay. Can you name some two neighboring countries of India? Two neighboring countries. Any two neighboring countries. Fine. Very good. Good, children. Very good. Very good. All these answers are correct. All these answers are correct. Very good. Yes. Okay. For our country, which is the natural border which can prevent invasions from our enemies, which is in the northern side? Very good. Good. Good, children. Really, I'm happy to see all the answers are correct because we have seen in 8th standard, 7th standard, all this you would have learned. Good. All your answers are correct. Okay, we follow one time that is called Indian Standard Time. Which longitude do you remember? Which longitude we have taken as a standard meridian? Which longitude? Okay, I will just give a clue. It is between 80 and 90. That longitude is between 80 and 90. So which longitude it is? It is between 80 and 90. Between 80 and 90. Divya, nearer. Very good, Darun. Anybody? 82 is nearer. Okay, I will tell you the answer. It is 82 and a half. Yes, very good. Good children. So thank you all. I'm happy. So we will meet in the next class. Monday onwards, we will start a new session. So thank you all, children. Thank you.